Joining us now for more on job creation and the debt ceiling agreement, Congressman Ron Paul, who voted against raising the debt ceiling. He says the new special committee created by Congress is, quote, disturbing and will be used instead to raise taxes. Congressman Ron Paul, seeking the Republican presidential nomination, joins us tonight from Clute, Texas. Good to have you with us, Congressman.
Thank you, Lou. Good to be with you.
You voted again against the debt ceiling. Tell us why.
Mainly because I've never voted for any of the spending, essentially, over the many years I've been in Congress. And I believe that debt was going to be a problem many years ago, and debt is a problem. So you don't get out of the problem of having too much debt by allowing the Congress to spend a lot more and granting them another $2.4 trillion worth of debt. So it never made any sense to me to do it that way. It just digs the hole much deeper, and then it gets harder for us to get out. So it was a very easy vote for me, but it became much easier when I saw the vehicle they were using to create this super Congress. I mean, where in the world did that come from, and what is that going to lead to? That is monstrous. I mean, I keep looking and looking. I can't find any place in the Constitution where we have the authority to create such a creature as the Super Congress.
Right. We want to, Congressman, if we may, we're taking just a moment here. This is obviously President Obama stepping down from Air Force One, arriving in Chicago for what will be a birthday celebration tonight in his hometown. You see him there with Mayor Rahm Emanuel, his former chief of staff. As the president gets ready for what will be a very busy and apparently festive and likely lucrative evening of fundraising, two fundraisers, one birthday bash. There is, as I said, the president and Mayor Emanuel in Chicago. Let's return to you, Congressman Paul. You're talking about the super committee. You know, I could never find anything in the Constitution that would satisfy, it seems to me, a reasonable man, namely myself, that there is any constitutional authority for fast-track authority for trade agreements. This super committee seems to be in that vein. How will you proceed?
That is exactly right. It's creating committees to do the job and assume the responsibility that Congress should do it. And you're absolutely right on the trade agreements. You know, I happen to think that these trade agreements and giving this responsibility to the executive branch is absolutely wrong. But it's not in the only area. I think writing regulations is actually writing law. So I'm way back on what the executive branch should do. But now for the OMB, it looks to me like with this super Congress and committee that if we don't vote for what they recommend, OMB gets a lot of power, and that's part of the executive branch. And who knows? That's the area where I think that they may be raising revenues, closing loopholes. Who knows what they might be doing? But it is not a good sign for constitutional government.
And the Supreme Court has slapped down a lawsuit brought by states and environmental groups that sought to push powers over greenhouse emissions. And the opinion written by Justice Ginsburg made it very clear that the EPA is the source and force in establishing those regulations and enforcing them. A remarkable decision by the Supreme Court. What is your reaction?
Well, I think it's rather clear in Article 1 that the Congress is supposed to write the law. This whole idea that any bureaucracy, any agency of government can write all these regulations, they're the law of the land. One of the most annoying statement I ever heard said was not only do they write the regulations, but what about the statement that Paul Begala said once, a stroke of the pen, law of the land, kind of cool. You know, that tells you what the attitude is, you know, about what they think about the Congress and what they think about the American people and what they think about the Constitution.
I think we should point out that was a very young and ebullient Paul Begala at the time.
he's settled down now.
and you still recognize him as a fellow Texan, do you?
Yeah, but I don't know about how what he would recognize me. That's the only thing.
Well, even reluctantly, I'm sure there's reciprocity among Texans. Congressman, it's great to have you with us. Always good to talk with you. Appreciate it.
Thank you, Luke.
Congressman Ron Paul. Well, here.